is 6:15 now, and good Sunday, day number two of this long weekend for some of you, and a lot of folks enjoying, of course, the 110th anniversary. All I could hear yesterday was potato, 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 potato.
You got a picture of a young Harley rider up here.
Of course, future hog rider, right? This is sent in by Jay and Peggy, so thanks for sharing this.
Looks like they're already riding a hog.
I know, it's got the little tiny one, little leather fringe on the side. Love it. Thanks for sending that picture. And of course, we've got a current hog rider. This is from Ted from Crystal River, Florida. And of course, there were lots of folks from all over the world at the parade yesterday. I saw some pictures from some folks in Australia, all over the world. Great way to celebrate. And you know what? Beautiful weather yesterday. Now today, kind of a different story. We've got that cold front on the way, and this is going to bring a chance for some showers and thunderstorms. Even had a severe thunderstorm warning already in Clark and Taylor counties this morning. That has expired, but you can see some of those showers and thunderstorms developing just ahead of the cold front. A lot more energy down to the south, though, and I think that's where the main focus for severe weather will be later on today down to our south, but still a chance for some showers and thunderstorms in our forecast. What we have to deal with this morning, though, is that dense fog advisory for most of southeastern Wisconsin until 8 o'clock this morning. And this is why. Take a live look right now from Waukesha. And you can see that visibility is lowered to about a quarter of a mile. Make sure you have those low beams on. We are going to be looking at this fog disappearing by about the time we get to 9 o'clock. But like I said, later on this afternoon, really watching that cold front advance, I think the main energy will be focused down to our south, where the Storm Prediction Center has issued a slight risk for strong storms. Note how we are not in this, but we could see a storm get a little overexcited. We could see some strong wind gusts as well as some heavy downpours as this cold front passes on through. Not everybody sees this rain, though. It's just a chance for those showers and thunderstorms to develop. We certainly have the heat and humidity to work some of those storms to get those energized. 83 degrees for our high today, so well above average. It is officially the first day of meteorological fall. Welcome to September. Don't forget to flip that calendar over. Here's that timing of that cold front, though, even though we won't feel quite like meteorological fall today because of humidity, because of those 80s. Here comes that cold front again, still dry about 11 o'clock and noon. I think after about 1 o'clock, that's when we're going to be watching showers and thunderstorms develop in our western counties. As we go throughout the evening hours, those start to spread to the east. I do expect by about 8-9 o'clock, those showers and thunderstorm chances to come to an end. We will be looking at a clear and dry overnight as high pressure starts to move in, pushing away the clouds, pulling down some of that cooler air. It will be cooler to start off your Labor Day. And as the kids head back to school, we're talking about pretty crisp fall-like conditions as we get a refreshing shot of cooler air as the jet stream has a dip as we go into early next week. Now, we are in September, so a few things that we're going to notice. The fog frequency, like we have this morning, going to start to increase. Same with hurricane frequency. Don't have to worry about that so much. Thunderstorm frequency is going to start to go down, as well as the daylight and the average temps. Although today, you wouldn't know that. 83 for our high again. Becoming westerly wind, showers mainly between 1 p.m. and 8 p.m. are those chances coming to an end by about 8-9 o'clock. 62 for a low tonight in Milwaukee, 58 in Waukesha, and tomorrow mostly sunny skies, a little taste of fall, 72 degrees, a little bit breezy as well with a northerly wind at 10 to 15, and then we warm up and stay mostly dry through the work week, Tom.
All right, Jesse, thank you very much. Milwaukee